I got a call from Microsoft and allowed them access to my computer. What do I do now? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. This is fundamentally a scam that has been going on, gosh, for over a decade. Here's an example question that I got some time ago. A family member got scammed by a telephone call from someone saying that they were from Microsoft and calling because of PC error reports. Unfortunately, remote access was given. What should be done to prevent further compromise of the PC data? Help! Note, the MS scanner and a Norton scan were done and showed no problems. Remote access software files were removed manually from the PC. Could the scammer again gain access to the PC data? Data is backed up to the external drive, not plugged in at the time of the scam. Can the same files and data be safely loaded onto a new hard disk and/or computer? So, as you've probably guessed by now, Microsoft does not call people because of errors on their computer. They will not call you out of the blue. And this is true for any number of variations of this particular scam. Your ISP, FedEx, your computer manufacturer, I mean, any number of different companies are represented when scammers try to use this scam to fool you. Most often than not, it is related to your computer, your ISP, your software, or something like that. The key is, of course, that they attempt to get you to give them remote access to your computer. Of course, that's exactly what they want. When they ask for that, very simply, don't do it. It's a trap. It is a scenario where once you've given them remote access, they can do all sorts of things to your computer potentially without your even seeing it happen. They could install malware. They might discover that they need to fix some non-existent problem on your machine, and in order to do so, you'll need to purchase something. You may be quoted a very high price for this quote-unquote service. If you provide payment information, well, you've just given a scammer your credit card information. They could go off and charge all sorts of things. But I want to focus on that first one. You've given them remote access, and they could install malware. This really goes to the very first part of the question, and that is, could they get back in? Even if my anti-malware tools report negative, if I've removed what I believe to be the remote access software that they had me install, is it still possible that they could have access to my computer? And unfortunately, the answer is yes. In fact, I don't even know how likely it is. But remember, malware can do anything. If they have the opportunity to install malware on your machine, they could, in theory, install a backdoor Trojan that doesn't reuse any of the common remote access tools, so anything you uninstall doesn't affect it, and could be something that continues to hide successfully from anti-malware tools. So it is possible. Now, one of the things that the scammers will often use, particularly with internet-related problems or Microsoft Windows-related problems, and I say problems in quotes here, is that they will have you open up the Event Viewer. The Event Viewer is a tool that views a log of issues and things that have gone on with your system for some time. It logs, well, events, as its name implies. Here's the issue. The Event Viewer is a mess. It's absolutely a mess. They will point to the Event Viewer. They will show you some log in the Event Viewer, and you will see lots of errors and warnings and all sorts of scary stuff that you, of course, won't understand, and that they, of course, will tell you that it's the sign of the apocalypse for your computer. Nothing could be further from the truth. The event viewer is a mess. Errors and warnings in the event viewer are completely normal. The contents of the event viewer are really meant to be understood only by technicians, and even then, some pretty advanced technicians. The bottom line here is that as soon as they try and point you at the event viewer as telling you something about your system, it's another sign. It's a scam. Don't fall for it. The bottom line here for avoiding this and honestly many other kinds of related scams is simply this. Never completely trust someone who calls you. If you get a call from someone you've never heard of, out of the blue, you need to be super suspicious. If they tell you that there's a problem, fine. Thank them. Let them know you'll find your local technician who is responsible for your machine, even if you don't have one, and hang up. That's the best solution. If you are concerned, if you really think that there might be an issue, great. Find someone yourself. Find someone you trust to have a look at the issue. You cannot trust anyone that calls you out of the blue in order to quote unquote help you with your computer. So, what do you do? You've fallen for the scam. You've let somebody access your machine remotely. What can you do? Well, unfortunately, the answer is not a lot. It's not something that you can, with any certainty, fix. You can't remove what you don't see, and you may not see it. You can't necessarily do anything to truly make sure, absolutely, that they didn't do something malicious to your machine while they had it. So, there are basically two approaches to this problem. Neither of them are great. One, assume the worst. Assume that whatever could go wrong has go wrong, and that your machine is no longer to be trusted. Therefore, you can either revert your machine to a system image backup that you took before any of this happened, and you're done. Or if you don't have a system image backup, then you're really faced with a reformat and reinstall of Windows. Back up your data first, but basically you need to then erase everything on your machine because you can't trust anything on your machine. Reinstall Windows, reinstall your apps, and then very carefully restore your data from the copy you made to start with. The other option, and it's unfortunate because it's really another extreme, and that is simply hope for the best. Run up-to-date antivirus and anti-malware scans, potentially run a couple of them to make sure you've got as much coverage as you can, and then hope. That's really all you can do at that point, is hope that they didn't leave something malicious behind. I know it's not an ideal solution. It's a really, really bad situation once you find yourself having fallen victim to these guys. And I get it. Most of the time, there may in fact not be a problem, but we just don't know. There's no way to prove it. As always, the best way to recover from this problem is to not have this problem to begin with. And ultimately, that means never, ever giving control of your computer to anyone that you don't absolutely trust. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/4863. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.